deck the halls with boughs of holly. It's the season.
We're talking about the business prospects for 2012. Welcome back to Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanjuatco-Trillo. In this segment, we'll focus on this year's outlook for franchising. And for that, we're joined by Butz Bartolome. He is the president of GMB Franchise Developers. Hello, Butz. Welcome back to Shop Talk.
Thank you, and Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Speaking of the New Year, we want to know from you, since you are the franchising guru, what are the franchising trends coming up this year in 2012?
Well, actually, I've been studying the trend for the last 5 years. You see, we have, since 1995, we have about 1,000 franchises already. And that growth tantamounts about 56% per year. So it's really jumping, and we have more and more franchises, business concepts that are proving their worth, no? But right now, for this year, the way I see it, there's a maturity level.
Okay.
The past years, we have been growing a lot of business concepts from local and as well as foreign that are coming in. But now it's more of the maturity stage that I see it. No? This is where you call the sustainability. This is where the big boys will really come into play. Like, for example, how well can you sustain your franchise business? And then the competition. Because competition will be coming in from the United States, from Europe. There are a lot of foreign franchises that will be coming in this year. But for the matured franchisors locally, they have to really gather their ranks. So like one, for example, how sustainable is your organization? When you say organization, you have these people who are servicing the franchisees. How well are you active in terms of research and development? You have to be creative here, no? But I always advise people, stay within your core. So, for example, if you're into hamburger, don't serve noodles, you know? Like, for example, look at Ray Kroc, the founder of McDonald's, till he died. He has been staying in his core competency, hamburgers, hamburgers, hamburgers. So that is one thing that I advise franchisors. And at the same time, look at cost. You know, the costs, they kept rising, especially the past year. And profitability has really gone down. So they have to be more or less playful in terms of being innovative. How do you keep your costs so that your franchisees will be profitable? Like, for example, the food business. It's so tricky.
Right.
Your profit will just be less. And there are so many alternatives that you can choose from. So that is one thing that I see now for this 2012.
Right. How do you strike the balance between sticking to your core competencies? The example you gave was the burgers by Ray Kroc, and also making room for creativity and evolving together with what the market is looking for.
Well, you have to listen to the market. For example, talking to your customers. You know, I always keep saying for 2012, we have to enforce training on our people. Like, how do you know whether your customers or what your customers are telling you? What products do they like? So, because you can just get it from hindsight, you can get it from friends, but it's your customers who are really dictating the market, where and what they want you to have. No, so that's one thing. No, like database. No, so that you'll be able to understand what the market trend is.
Right, okay. And for people looking into going into business, why is franchising a good option?
You know what? With the matured franchisors, you are assured there is systems, there are procedures, and there is a brand, no? Because if you're just starting a business right now, it's going to be tough. Like, for example, locations. How do you set locations? How do you know, how do you train your people? Where do you get professionals to manage your business? If it will be on a mom and pop stage, the growth will be less. No, it will take years. Plus the fact there's a lot of room, a lot of trial and error. No, in franchising, you're assured that this brand will grow because through the test of time. That is the reason why, between choosing a franchise and starting your own business, most people I always advise, get into a franchise, learn the ropes, And soon you will realize the benefits that you are really, you're really gaining here.
Right. You mentioned profitability. So it would really be more profitable to go with the franchise, or profitable in the sense it's a little safer because there's a formula.
It's really safe because in franchising, the franchisor has the leverage with suppliers. For example, between a mom and pop store, you won't be able to get any credit from your suppliers, probably COD or cash on delivery.
Right.
Franchisor will probably say, I have the volume, I have the branches, give me a better deal so I can pass this on to the franchisees.
I see. Okay, and specifically now, talking about the different franchises, what are the kinds of concepts you think will flourish in 2012?
Well, now I see the quick service. Because there are a lot of, in the provinces that I've seen the last year, there's so many new concepts that are coming out. And these are quick service restaurants. But gone are the fad, no? Please stay away from the fad. These are, you know, the quick, and then they just disappear.
Right.
You know? This is something that you have to be watchful for. The services aspect is also making their round, no? Now, for example, you have the preschool, you have the tutorial, you have buy-in center, for example, the convenience stores. These are now the trend, no?
Mm-hmm.
Because people now look at it as a service, as a convenience, no?
Right.
So that's the trend that I see now for 2012.
Okay, one huge, I don't know, again, if this is something you can call a fad or if it's here to stay, but everybody is crazy about milk tea. And there's so many different milk tea brands popping up, whether they're local or they're from other Asian countries. Do you consider that to be a fad, or you think it's something
this is a comeback. Way back years ago, there used to be a milk tea craze, no? And now I see the corn niche, you know, there's a niche that these players are now working on. They have the backup system, they have the good marketing promotion, and the quality, no? Most of the milk tea companies that I've seen, they're really concentrating on quality as well as pricing, no? So this is not really a fad for me right now, because it's on a second time around, no?
I see.
So that's a better way of getting into the business, considering the profitability. These are drinks, no? Not food. So the profit margin may be greater here.
Okay. So it's also, as a entrepreneur venturing into this, you want to really study the milk tea company that you're going to buy into or franchise.
You have to investigate first. No? Another trend that I see now is that all these pseudo franchises will start to disappear. Because later on, the government is now starting to come up with regulations because of the so many complaints in the past of scam franchisors.
Okay.
And these are victimizing especially our overseas Filipinos.
Right, to invest in them.
So, and there are also associations that are now self-policing their ranks. So little by little, I see now that in this coming year, we will now be easing out all those scams. No? Hopefully eradicate them, if not totally.
Right.